Hey guys, welcome to the new video. Have you noticed how our learning style has shifted in the last 15 years? We used to learn everything from books. These days, almost everything is on screen. But is it a better style of learning or more effective? Today, we often talk about multimedia learning, which offers interactive, engaging content. It's simply more fun. We get to learn from various inputs such as text, images, audio, video, animations and other interactive elements. However, it can sometimes be overwhelming, lack of structure, distractions. I recently stumbled upon a book that piqued my interest, The Cambridge Handbook of Multimedia Learning by Richard Mayer. This book is a total game changer. While reading this book, I found it packed with scientific research that's presented in a way that's both practical and applicable. One of the core concepts in the book is the cognitive load. Language learning can be cognitively demanding. So understanding how multimedia affects the cognitive load can help in optimizing our learning process. In this video, I will be sharing some interesting insights from the book. If you are feeling overwhelmed with all the different learning resources out there, this video is for you. So let's get into the video. The pre-training principles suggest that people learn more effectively when they are introduced to the main concept before diving into the detailed content. In other words, having a basic understanding of the key ideas beforehand can make the deeper content more accessible and easier to grasp. I love watching news and documentaries. I believe they are the best ways to practice listening and learn new words. Instead of diving directly into the content based on this principle, it's more effective to first learn some basic information about a topic in our native language or a language we fluent in before watching it in our target language. For instance, if I find a video about climate change in German that I want to use it as a study material, I might read quickly about the topic in English or French before I study the German content. This approach can help me understand the content better. The redundancy principle asserts that people learn better from graphics and narration rather than graphics, narration, and on-screen text. In simpler terms, when you have a visual like a graphic or animation combined with narration, it's usually not beneficial to also include the same information on-screen text. The redundant on-screen text can split the learner's attention and reduce the effectiveness of the learning experience. For example, you are watching a Spanish movie. The characters are speaking in Spanish. And there are also Spanish subtitles on the screen matching the spoken words. You might think that both listening to the dialogue and reading the same dialogue in Spanish would enhance our comprehension. I used to think the same. However, according to this principle, having identical spoken and written content could split your attention. Your cognitive resources might become divided between reading and listening, making it harder to effectively process the information from either source. Redundant on-screen text can overload the learner's cognitive system. If you really want to practice both reading and listening, you can watch a scene once without subtitles, then rewatch it with the Spanish subtitles to check a comprehension and catch anything you missed. I often watch video first without the subtitles to pick up on the language, and then again with subtitles to learn new words. Sometimes I skip that initial step and jump straight to watching with subtitles. But now I realize that this approach might not be as effective. I should probably focus more on listening the first time around. For instance, on platforms like Lingopie, you will find videos, series, and movies in various languages. They provide dual subtitles and even allow you to click on words for instant translations. I believe the best way to use this platform is to first watch the videos without subtitles, practicing your listening skills, then turn on the subtitles to concentrate on reading and learning new words. Signaling principle. People learn better when there are clear signs or hints pointing them to the main ideas. Imagine you are studying a text by using a PDF textbook. You might assume that diving straight into the content will allow you to grasp everything as you go along. But according to this principle, not having clear markers or cues can leave you feeling lost or overwhelmed. Without signals to guide you, you might not know which parts are the key concept and which are just supplementary details. The rationale behind this principle is straightforward. When our brains know where to focus, we can process information more efficiently and remember it better. A more effective way is to create your own signaling system. As you go through the lesson, use different markers to highlight new words or grammar points. It's also important to jot down keywords and create your own outline that illustrates the main points to guide your understanding. By the end, you will know exactly what you have learned and what the key takeaways are. The segmenting principle. People learn better when content is presented in manageable chunks or segments rather than a continuous unit. When faced with a long continuous stream of information, learners might become overwhelmed or lose track of the main point. Research has shown that our working memory has a limited capacity. So when information is chunked, it takes up less space in our working memory, allowing for more efficient processing. In the past, I used to study an entire long text in one go, thinking it was the best way to immerse myself. The problem with this approach is that we often feel overwhelmed and lose concentration towards the end. It isn't helpful for understanding and absorbing information. But now I'm trying the segmenting principle. I break my learning into manageable chunks. Instead of watching a long video or reading a long article, I divide the study time into shorter, focused sessions, separating them into different chunks based on the content. For example, the timestamps on YouTube videos can often help us create chunks. It also helps me have a clear structure of the content after studying. This method also aligns well with scientific research on human attention and concentration. Studies have consistently shown that our focus tends to wane after about 20 to 25 minutes of continuous work or study. This phenomenon is often referred to as the attention decay curve. It's not just about the duration of a concentration, but also the quality of it. Another way to use this principle, we can pick from the catalog your favorite series on LingoPy and start learning. You can click on new words and add them to the learning list. This allows you to cut complex material into small parts. Then you can study and review new words in isolation after you've seen their usage in context. Not only that, you can also study grammar separately and you can control the amount of time you spend studying. If you want to try out LingoPy, you can click the link in the description box. The self-explanation principle emphasizes that people understand and remember material better when they explain it to themselves as they learn. To put it simply, when you watch videos in a foreign language, it's incredibly beneficial to pause occasionally and talk through what you've understood. By doing so, you actively engage with the material and enhance your comprehension. I used to watch French films and series to improve my language skills. I had a trick that fit really well with this principle. Instead of just watching and hoping I catch every nuance, I sometimes pause the video, especially after important scenes or dialogues. For example, after a particularly emotional scene in a French drama where two characters have a heated argument, I might pause and say to myself, "All right, the main character is upset because of the secret that was revealed. She used the word trahi, which means to betray. So she feels betrayed by her friend because he kept that information from her." This act of internal narration helps me process the emotions, the context, and most importantly, the language nuances of the scene. I ensure that I understand both the storyline and the language being used. If you have a language partner, it's even better. You can explain what you've read and watched recently. If what we discussed today resonated with you, I would highly recommend giving the book a read. There are so many more fascinating aspects to explore. Now I'm curious to know, what are your thoughts on multimedia learning? Have you experienced any struggles or challenges with it? Or perhaps you've found certain multimedia tools or strategy particularly effective? Please share your experiences in the comments below. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. See you in the next one. Bye!